once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered weak and weary over a many quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, while I nodded nearly napping, suddenly there came a tapping, as of someone gently rapping at my chamber door. "'Tis some visitor," I muttered, "tapping at my chamber door. Only this, and nothing more." into the darkness peering. Long I stood there wondering, fearing, doubting, dreaming dreams no mortal ever dared to dream before. But the silence was unbroken, and the stillness gave no token, and the only word there spoken was the whispered word, Lenore. This I whispered, and an echo murmured back the word, Lenore. Merely this and nothing more.
Mum? Mum, are you home from work? You're just hearing things.
Now, can you hear me? I swear to God I will make you pay for this.
Thank you.
Police? There's someone in my house.
Bethany.
Tony. Tony! Tony!
Bethany! Open the door, Bethany!
Let me out! Please, God, let me out!
Prophet, I said, thing of evil, prophet still, if bird or devil, by that heaven that lies above us, by that God we both adore, tell this soul with sorrow laden, if within the distant Aden it shall clasp a saintly maiden, whom the angels name Lenore, clasp a rare and radiant maiden, whom the angels name Lenore, croaked the raven, nevermore. Thank you. On the pallid bust of Pallas just above my chamber door, and his eyes have all the seeming of a demon's that is dreaming, and the lamplight o'er him streaming throws his shadow on the floor, and my soul from out that shadow that lies floating on the floor shall be lifted. Nevermore.